You are tuned to Coast Community Radio. Here's Cindy Lauffer. The Goonies are good enough.
The Goonies was filmed in the seaside town of Astoria in Oregon, 2 hours northwest of Portland. It's a town that's become the place for children of the 80s to celebrate their love of the truffle shuffle, and where thousands now visit the filming locations used in the movie.
We grew up as Goonies fans, and so we had to come to Astoria to kind of compare everything that we've seen in the movies to all the places we could possibly find. We've had the DVD going all the way from Oklahoma. It's good to see something that was with me for such a long time as a kid, and these guys as well. And now just getting to experience it all with our little ones.
Come on!
Standing in front of it, it's just mind-blowing.
Grown-up Goonies head straight for the city jail building. Virtually nothing has changed since filming took place in 1984, inside and out.
Well, every Goonies fan recognizes this as the Goonies Jeep. The Fratellis, the bad guys, and it's an exact replica from the movie down to every detail. The fan that made this went to just extreme things. It's the exact same replica year, it's the same color, and he did everything right down to even the bullet holes. Oh, for Goonies fans, it's a dream come true. It's stepping into the movie that they love. This is the jail cell from the movies. It's not a set. I mean, it was a set, but it's a real place. And they can step right into the jail cells. The Fratellis aren't here, but the jail cells are here. And right out in front is the Goonies Jeep. So Mama Fratelli's maybe getting ready to get out of here with them. They can make their own movie. They can pretend to be driving the Jeep from the movie. And it's just a lot of fun. It's Goonies come to life.
The most iconic Goonies location in Astoria is a little house on a hill in the east of the town, known as the Goondocks. The property was used as the Walsh House in the movie, and since 2001 has been owned by Sandi Preston, who struggles with her piece of pop culture history.
When I first bought the house, it hadn't been lived in for a number of months, so it was run down, and I think probably a few people walked up to see it, but not a lot. And then in 2005, when we had the first reunion, it was a lot of publicity, so more and more people started coming. And so this past summer, the man down at the bottom of the hill did a clicker, and it's like over 1,000 people a day. And so you can imagine what it's like getting up in the morning and there could be 50 people milling around out in front of your house.
The house is on a private driveway, but visitors are welcome to have a look, provided they keep their distance. Most are respectful, but many often test Sandy's patience. Her neighbors have long since grown tired, though, of the intrusion from fans.
The Goonies house has been attracting people for many years. Unfortunately, the people decide to walk up there as early as 4:30 in the morning, and I've seen people as late as 11 o'clock at night. There used to be something called common courtesy of, you know, respectable hours.
It's sometimes difficult to get anything done because people want to ask questions and everything, and I enjoy that for the most part, but I don't want this to seem like a horribly negative thing, because I really, really care about most of the people who come here.
However warm the welcome may be, Goonies fans keep on coming to Astoria, and now in even greater numbers for the film's 30th anniversary.
You are tuned to Coast Community Radio, KMUN Astoria, KTCB Tillamook, and it's time, everybody, it's Goonies Weekend.
That's right, the 30th anniversary of the Goonies. Everyone get ready to do the massive truffle shuffle. Get your tickets at the Liberty Theater box office in Astoria.
The town makes a small fortune from the fans' appetite for merchandise.
We started the first Goonies anniversary event in 2005, and we ordered probably a tenth of what we ordered for this year's event and sold out within a day, pretty much, of, you know, the general sizes, the larges and mediums were gone in all of our shirts. So when we did the event again in 2010 for the Goonies 25th anniversary, we thought we really overbought and had tons of stuff, and again, sold out of most everything before the weekend was over. This year, I'm hoping that we've ordered enough to get through the weekend and have some stuff in our visitor center for folks that come to see the sights from the Goonies throughout the summer in Astoria.
And my name is Mick Alderman.
I was present on the set of the motion picture The Goonies for the 3 weeks that they shot in my hometown of Astoria in Oregon.
Mick joined the production team at Cannon Beach, just south of Astoria. There are two Goonies filming locations there, Ecola State Park, where Mikey and his pals start their adventure, and also Haystack Rock. Michael was an intern to the film's director, Richard Donner.
The cast members were all minors. They were only permitted by law to work for 4 hours a day. So because the shoot, you know, typically lasted 12 hours or more, that's only a third of the day. So what they did was they kept the kids in a trailer going to school because they had to have a certain amount of schooling. And there was a person there literally with a stopwatch, and when Richard Donner was ready for a shot, the kids would be hustled up to the set, they'd get in front of the camera, they would do the shot, Richard Donner would call cut, new setup, and the kids would be hustled back down to the trailer. So that was it. There was never any off time on the set.
Of course, no Goonies celebration would be complete without an appearance from One-Eyed Willy.
We've made One-Eyed Willy for the fans that are coming to Astoria for the Goonies 30th anniversary this weekend. It's been a couple of months of work trying to figure out how to get him to operate. And they will come around to on the treasure hunt, find him, and then using clues, lift his eye patch to discover the code, which he will speak when they lift the eye patch.
My goal!
As One-Eyed Willy's ship sets sail once again for the Goonies' 30th anniversary, it's clear that fans will continue to celebrate the film's legacy for many more years to come.